hello. So today I'm surf fishing at Black's Beach, La Jolla. It's a bit cloudy today, but that's honestly alright since I won't really have to worry about the sun hitting the back of my neck. It's actually my first or second time actually trying to do some surf fishing, so my expectations are pretty low. I'm honestly just hoping that I catch something, anything really. So the combo that I'm running today is a Shakespeare Alpha Bigwater spinning 12-foot rod with a Quantum Blue Runner 80 reel. And it's spooled with some 30-pound monofilament. I recently got both the rod and reel on off-rope for about 20 bucks, which I think is a pretty good deal. I'm also trying out a high-low rig with some size 3/0 hooks and some frozen shrimp from Ralph's for bait. Attached to the rig are 2 1-ounce pyramid sinkers, since that's all I honestly had to work with. I've also never really casted a rod quite as large as this one, so I'm expecting to struggle just a little bit. I officially had my first cast around 7:30 in the morning, and from there I just kept trying to see if I can get any fish to take my bait. It took me a little while, but after a couple of casts, I think I got a bit better by the end of the day, but not by much. I wasn't really getting the distance that I was hoping for, so I started walking into the ocean to cast from the surf to see if I can get some more distance on my throws. At this point, the water was up to my ankles and we were approaching high tide. So things weren't really looking up, and after a couple more casts into the unknown and a lot more waiting for absolutely nothing to bite my shrimp, I did eventually get some seaweed at the end of my line. So that was a little bit annoying and it was kind of a bit of a tease, but I guess that's better than absolutely nothing, and I did say that I would be okay with catching anything really. So after I unhooked the seaweed and threw it onto the sandy shore, I went back into the ocean to throw out my line and honestly wait for a miracle. So, at this point, I was really starting to get pretty desperate, since I was only getting the occasional bite here and there, and my bait kept getting pushed back towards the shore. So I started wading deeper and deeper into the ocean to really try to get it as far as I possibly could. At this point, the water was up to my waist and the waves were hitting me in the chest and splashing me on my face, so it was getting pretty rough to go any further into the ocean. So nothing was really biting out there, and I was just about to move to another spot until I felt like something huge just hit my line. So I got really excited and began walking towards the surf, but I soon realized that it really wasn't jerking around like how a fish who just got stabbed in the mouth normally would. But you know, I was still pretty optimistic, and I thought maybe, just maybe, that it had just swam towards the shore instead of away from it. So I started reeling it in as I walked towards the surf. Then I really felt my rod bend when an incoming wave pushed whatever was at the end of my line towards me, and I began to think, finally.
What is this? God, even more seaweed, why?
Yes, why? I freaking got more seaweed again, and as it began to take it off, I was thinking I would just try one more time to see if anything could happen. So I rebaited my line with more shrimp and headed out towards the surf once again. Yeah, so I didn't get any more bites, and I decided to move to another spot where other people were. The sun had just come out, and so did a bunch of nude beachgoers, since Black's Beach is actually a nudist beach, which is, I guess pretty interesting. I definitely didn't want to look around my peripheral since I was filming and all that, plus that would be kind of rude. After many throws, I was seeing some improvement with my casting.
There it is.
Despite the waves still pummeling my face about every 5 seconds.
Woo!
Okay, the moment we've been waiting for, something definitely just hit my line, and after a quick check to see if it was still there, it was, and I was off, reeling away. I've come way too far to go home empty-handed, and I wasn't gonna let this fish get away from me. And as I kept reeling, reeling, I could feel that it was really trying to fight back, but it was futile as I dragged it out of the ocean and onto the shore. I had done it. I finally caught my first fish ever on the surf. As I raced back to my backpack, with my fish dangling from my pole and almost tripping over a hole, I could feel the rush of excitement run through my veins as the realization that all of my hard work was well worth it. I had been vindicated. No matter what happened today, I was victorious, and almost nothing could change that. This was my first fish from the surf, and I really couldn't believe it. I was honestly so glad that I was recording just before my camera died, as it truly would have been so sad if I couldn't get it on film, as this is something I don't ever want to forget. My camera was actually about to die, so after a few more casts to use up the rest of my bait, I decided to leave. I didn't catch anything else, unfortunately, but there were a few nibbles here and there, so it was all still pretty good. I took the fish home, and after a quick text to a friend and a simple Google search, I was informed that I caught a barbed surf perch, which is a pretty common fish around the La Jolla, San Diego area. When I got back to my place, I immediately took its measurements and saw that it was 10 inches from tail to mouth, and it weighed around 12 ounces, which is apparently a pretty good size, since most of the adult surf perch don't get bigger than 12 inches, with most of them being around 6.5 inches long. Oh, and this is me now just doing a quick descaling and wash before I gut it. So I'm actually pretty ill-equipped when it comes to gutting fish, since my go-to is just a fruit knife that I've used for, you know, pretty much everything. I thought it'd be enough, but I was terribly wrong, and I had to switch to a regular kitchen knife, which I also had some difficulty with to cut open the fish. Eventually, I was able to cut it open, and as I took out its guts, I opened up the stomach, and I was surprised to see that it had a whole bunch of little clamshells in its belly. Like, the entire stomach was full, and there must have been around 30 or so, at least, of these tiny little shells. Oh, and also the shrimp that I caught the fish on, so that was a really cool dissection. A quick Google search told me that these little clam shells came from bean clams, which only grow up to be around 15 to 25 millimeters, so they're pretty tiny. I then began to chop off the head with a quick cut under the fin past the collar, and I did this to both sides of the fish, and then off went the head. Then with a quick rinse, I ripped out the rest of the guts, did another quick rinse trying to get rid of all the remaining blood, slime, and guts. Next, off went the tail. With a pair of scissors, I began to cut off all of the fins, which on the barred surf perch are actually pretty sharp, especially the dorsal ones, which are the one closest to its head. After another quick rinse, I cut off the rest of the remaining fins, and when I was going in for a final rinse, I accidentally dropped the perch into a bowl of soapy water, which I quickly took out. No big deal. 5 second rule applies here, right? Afterwards, I patted the fish dry with some napkins and put it in the fridge so I could cook it up for later. So I wanted to keep this recipe pretty simple. I just used some butter, salt, and pepper to cook it up. I heated up the pan on medium high and threw in just about a tablespoon of butter. I had already scored the fish beforehand and seasoned it with some salt, so all I had to do was throw it in the melted butter. As I was cooking it, I put some black pepper on the pan, and after a couple of minutes, it was done. The skin was pretty crispy, but the texture of the fish was complete mush and not at all flaky. I still ended up eating the whole thing because the taste was pretty good. I did a quick Google search, and it turns out that most surf perch get really mushy whenever you guys like would pan fry it. So maybe next time I'll throw it in some soup or, you know, make some fish balls out of it. Anyway, I'm still very much a beginner when it comes to fishing, especially surf fishing. So any sort of tips would be extremely helpful for me. So leave them down in the comments. Anyway, that's all for me today. Thank you. Have a good day. Goodbye for now. Bye.
I'm sick of daydreaming, I just want the feeling of you in my bed. I'm down to just waste time, right below your waistline, want you by my head.